Humble Heart Horsemanship. My name is Sabrina and this is my horse Gunner, and today we are going to be talking about bitless riding. So the first thing that I would like to cover is the definition of what bitless riding is. It seems pretty self-explanatory, but bitless riding is riding your horse without a bit, so not using any leverage that bits provide. A question that a lot of people have about bitless riding is who can ride bitless? And the answer to that, or the simple answer to that, is everyone. So horses of different backgrounds, of different disciplines, of different training levels, all of that sort of stuff, anyone can ride bitless with their horse, but it's important to understand that you have to train your horse to ride bitless like you would train them to ride in a bit. Some people might choose to ride bitless with their horse if their horse has a really sensitive mouth, or maybe the horse has an injury in its mouth that would make wearing a bit really uncomfortable. Also, bitless riding is really great for inexperienced riders who have really wobbly, jiggly hands and they don't really understand how to have super quiet, relaxed hands. So we can help to preserve the horse's mouth better if we ride bitless. As equestrians, one of our biggest focus, and what our focus should be, is making our horses as comfortable as they can possibly be. I think that riding bitless is something that can really add into that equation. A lot of horses you'll find will be more receptive, more relaxed, more comfortable when you ride them bitless. So I think that all horses and riders should at least explore bitless options. So some people think that they can only control their horse if they ride him with a bit. And in reality, I have been on horses that were both wearing a bit and not wearing a bit when they have bolted or done other dangerous things. And in reality, look how huge these horses are. Like, they can take off of you, do whatever they want. They're huge, very powerful, very dangerous, and very strong. So regardless of whether you have a bit or not, that's not gonna save you. What's gonna save you is having a really solid relationship with your horse and a horse that understands and is trained well. But the thing is, all different bitless bridles work differently. So you have to do your research and really understand how each bitless bridle works, where the pressure points are applied, because sometimes your horse may not like one bitless bridle versus another. So you're gonna have to try a lot of different options, maybe before you find one that works perfectly for your horse. Because all different bitless bridles have different pressure points and where they're applying that pressure, it's really important that you understand what cues that you need to use so that you're actually working with the bitless bridle versus against it. Sometimes you might have to learn different cues or just alter them just a little bit, and that's another thing to really consider. There are a lot of different bitless options. There's the mechanical hackamore, there's the Indian hackamore, there's a side pole, there's the rope halters, there's also the cross under bridles like the Dr. Cook bridles. So they all apply different pressure points. You really need to educate yourself on how they work. Your horse will definitely tell you what they feel more comfortable with and the ones that they don't like. So you really have to filter through, go through a lot of them, figure it out, pay attention to how your horse is feeling, and then from there, you can start educating yourself more on other aspects of bitless riding. Right now, I'm riding Gunner in a side pole. With the side pole, it relies off of direct pressure. So if I pull back on this right rein, he feels that pressure on the right side of his nose and he yields to the pressure when he feels it and turns in this way. Similar to how you would ride in a snap pole where you're using your direct reining cues. With like a Dr. Cook's bitless bridle, there's a lot of cross under action under the horse's jaw. Side of the horses underneath of their jaw. When you pull this one, it's going to apply pressure over here. And the Indian hackamore is really similar to that as well. It has the cross under action. Also a hackamore. Which applies pressure on the pole, which is between the horse's ears right here, and it also applies pressure underneath of the horse's chin and on their nose. And a bell applies pressure on the horse's face, on their nose, and underneath of their chin. that relies on direct pressure too, rather than leverage. So as you can tell, there's a lot of different bitless options out there and they all apply pressure differently. So it's just important to consider that when you're looking into it. Also understand that, you know, exploring bitless options is a journey. It's not something that you're going to likely try the first bitless bridle, it's gonna work perfectly, and you're gonna ride off into the sunset from there. It's gonna take a little bit of trial and error. So be patient, understand that it's a journey, enjoy yourself, and learn from it. Just like with everything new, it's going to take time. So you have to enjoy the ride, enjoy the process, enjoy your horses. Gunner's ready to go. He's like, lock it away, but goodbye. And Gunner came back and wanted me to tell you guys that you need to subscribe and like this video so that we can make more. Thank you.